Well, how you doing today, guys? Welcome back to another video. This is Alex, MTB Alex, and today we're gonna be doing a little bit of math. Before I show you what we're gonna do, please, if you haven't subscribed and turned the notification bell on, if you're new here, welcome to my channel where we do a lot of mountain bike stuff and a little bit of everything on the side as well. And if you want to support the channel, you can go ahead and check the affiliate links in the description below. And other than that, let's get right into it. So, this video has been on my bucket list for a long time because I have always wanted to do this. I have always wanted to show you how to actually find the actual chain size whenever you're installing a new chain or changing your drivetrain. In order to do that, there's a formula that I found online, and that's what I've been using on my bikes to properly size a chain. And with that said, let's get right into the equation. All right, again, so to get the chain length, we have a formula, and the formula stands L equals 2 times C plus parentheses F over 4 plus R over 4 plus 1. And again, I got this from ilovebicycling.com, and this is the actual formula to do this. I think Park Tools also have this formula and another more advanced formula, but this is super easy to work with. Let me show you. L stands for the actual length that you're going to have to cut your chain once you do the formula. The C stands for the chain stay length. The F stands for the chain ring number of teeth at the front. You're going to use, if you have more than one chain ring up front, you're going to use the largest cog. And R of course stands for the rear number of teeth, and of course you're going to use the largest cog. Now, C, chain stay. For example, if I have a bike, my chain stay length is going to be right here. So you're going to measure this distance from the center of the bottom bracket to the center of the quick release or where the true axle is at. So that length is going to tell you what you're going to use for C. In the case of my blue axon, because I already did it for my blue axon, the L for the blue axon in my case is going to be, the C for the blue axon is going to be 17 1/8. So 1 to 5, 17 1/2. At front, I have 32 tooth. And in the rear, my largest cog is 50. All I gotta do is put this into the equation and it'll give me how much of a change I need to have. So in this case, I'm gonna start substituting the values. L equals 2 times 17.125 plus 32 divided by 4 plus 50 divided by 4 plus 1. So when I multiply 2 times 17.125, I get 34.25. Then add, this can all come down, 32 divided by 4 is just 8, plus 50 divided by 4 is 12.5, plus 1. All you have to do now is add everything up. So when I do this, I get the length that I want my chain to be, it'll be 55 3/4 inches. This length is in the inches. So now what you want to see is where your breaking point is at, and then just round either up or down. So in this case, I would probably use round to 56 total, unless my breaking point is going to be right at 55 3/4. So you just got to play with that. Half an inch, quarter, 3/4 of an inch is not gonna affect that much, but this is how you actually find it. Now, if you wanna do, you don't wanna do this calculation, I actually made a little formula on an Excel sheet. Let me show you. So I made this sheet the other day, and all I gotta do is put in the chainstay length. For example, if my chainstay, let's keep on talking about the axle, for example, and let's say I have 32 at front, and my rear one is, I don't know, maybe the 40 standard cassette. So when you do that, your actual chain length, it'll be 52 and 3/4. That's the actual one. I think the stock is 32 at the front. So this should be the actual length of the chain if you take it out. Now let's do a few more combinations. Let's say you upgrade to a 42 tooth at the rear, same up front, you get 53.25. And then let's say, you know what? I'm just gonna get a goat link and get a 46 tooth, same eight. The number of speed doesn't matter right here. Now your chain length should be 54.25. Let's say you get a 32 tooth with a 46 combination, 54 3/4. Let's say you get a 51 tooth at the rear, 51 with a 32 tooth up front. Your combination should give you 56 even. So see, this is a really simple formula. I have it on this thing right here that I was playing it with the other day. So I just put some commands in there, not commands, just formulas in there to give me this automatically. So I can play with this however I want to. But you can always come back to this formula and find the exact measurement you need. So in the next slide, I'm going to leave you a few different ones, combinations. So if you learned something today, please give it a thumbs up. If you know somebody that's going through this process, this video is going to help them a lot. So share this video with them. If you haven't subscribed, please do so and turn the notification bell on, that way you don't miss any future content. And other than that, that is going to be it for this one, guys. Let's ride. See you on the trails. Goodbye.